Welcome to Oxford Instruments video guide to the OptiStat-Dry. How to run the first test. If you are running the first test yourself, make sure you have read the system manual and other relevant material. You must understand all of the health and safety information before you start to run your system. If you have paid for an Oxford Instruments engineer to install your system, we will do all of this section for you. Turn on the Mercury ITC. If the screen does not come up, check the power is turned on at the back of the temperature controller. Remove the blank from the OVC vacuum valve and open the valve to release the vacuum inside the cryostat. Unscrew the two thumb knobs and remove the sample access plate. Put this somewhere safe where it will not get damaged. Unscrew the four bolts holding the radiation shield plate by two or three turns. Lift the radiation shield plate and remove it. This plate contains the sorption pump, which needs to be conditioned each time the sample space is accessed. Place it on the hot plate at 100 degrees Celsius until you're ready to refit it. It should be heated for a minimum of 10 minutes. Connect the pumping line to the vacuum valve and check that the valve is still open. Refit the radiation shield plate to the cryostat. Please note, this will now be hot, so you must take care not to burn yourself. Tighten the bolts to the correct torque to ensure good thermal contact. Refer to the system manual for full details. Refit the sample access plate. Immediately, turn on the vacuum pump. Pump the cryostat for a minimum of 2 hours. You should achieve a pressure below 10 to minus 4 millibar. Whilst the cryostat is pumping down, change the set point on the Mercury ITC to 300 Kelvin and select auto mode. The cryostat will now control at 300 Kelvin. This will help improve the vacuum whilst the system is being pumped. When the cryostat pumping is finished, stop the 300 Kelvin temperature control and set the temperature to 0 Kelvin and manual mode. Close the OVC vacuum valve, turn off the vacuum pump and disconnect the pumping line. Start the compressor and the cryostat will begin cooling. Check the cryostat reaches base temperature as per your system test data sheet. Leave the cryostat at base temperature for approximately 1 hour. Set the temperature to 300 Kelvin again and leave the cryostat to control at this temperature for 1 hour. Switch off the compressor and allow the system to fully warm up. This is the end of the first test. If you want any more information, see our OptiStat-Dry videos or visit our website.